Hello children, today in moral science we are going to study lesson 13, that is father of all. Okay, who's the father of all? God is the father of all. The almighty God, the almighty power is above all. In our homes we have a father as the head of the family. So in our home, who's the head of the family? Our father. God is the father of all. And who's the father of all fathers, or who's the father of everyone? It is God. He's the father of everyone. He's above all. He's the creator of the universe. So this father, who is the father of everyone, he has created, he has formed this universe. God is our common father, means he's father of everyone. He's a common father. We all are his children. Everyone on the earth, we all are children of this father. So we all are brothers and sisters, and because we are children of the same father, so we all are brothers and sisters. We call him by different names, and we all call this father by different names. Like Hindus call him Ishwar, Muslims call him Allah, Christians call him God, and Sikhs call him Waheguru. So he has got a different name, but he is one. In the same manner, Parsis, Jains and Buddhists call him by different names. These different names are used by people of different religions, because we know that India is such a diverse country. There are so many religions, traditions, cultures are there in India. So different religion people call God by different names. Though God is one and the same, people of different religion worship him in different ways. So as the names are different, so the places of worship is also different. Like Hindus worship him in temples, Muslims worship him in mosques, Christians worship him in church, and Sikhs worship him in gurudwaras. The founders of various religions taught us that there is only one God. So there is only one God. Like Prophet Muhammad taught that there is one God who is merciful and compassionate, and he was his paigambar. So they call him a paigambar, and they say that he's so kind and so lovable, and he loves everyone. Jesus Christ said that he was a paigambar, means he has a direct contact with the God. Jesus Christ said that he was the Son of God, who is the creator of heaven and earth. And in Christians, they worship Jesus Christ, and they call that Jesus Christ was the Son of God, and he is the creator of heaven and earth. He also taught that God is only one. So Jesus Christ taught them that God is only one. Hindus also strongly believe that reality is one, and thus God is also one. Buddha taught that all human beings are equal before God, and Buddha also said, Lord Buddha said that human beings are equal before God. We all are equal. There is no discrimination among the humans. When we utter the words Ishwar, Allah, God or Waheguru, etc., we mean the same supreme being, the creator and ruler of this universe. Although we call him by different names, but we know that there is only one creator of God. He has no definite body or form. He is just a spirit that is all powerful, present everywhere and knows everything. And this creator of the universe, he is the supreme power. No one is powerful than him, and he has no definite shape, no definite size. He can come in any form. It is just the spirit which is very powerful. People of all religions pray and worship the same Lord of all. His will is supreme, and nobody can go against it. So even we try, we cannot go against the wish of God. Whatever God wants, we have to follow the same thing. God governs the universe according to his laws. The universe is moving in perfect harmony and order. The day breaks, the sun shines in the east and sets in the west. So who governs the universe? God. God governs the universe according to his laws, according to the laws formed by the God. And the universe is moving in perfect peace and harmony and proper order. The day breaks, the sun shines in the east and sets in the west. It's not like, you know, one day the sun is coming out from the west, one day the sun is coming out in the east. No, always the day breaks, the sun shines in the east and it sets in the west. And the night falls, then the moon appears, then the star appears, then the rain falls, plants and trees grow. So it is set on a set pattern, the universe is going smoothly. Then season changes, young ones grow, you know, everything goes on regularly in a perfect order. Divine laws are uniform and unchanging. So these laws are permanent, they will not change. Everything moves in order because there is only one God who controls them. So who is the supreme controller, who is the supreme power? That is God. He controls everything. So these things are unchangeable. They will not change. All paths lead to one destination. All rivers flow to one great ocean. All cultures make one world. All religions lead us to one God. So people of all religions must live in harmony as they are created by one and the same God. So like, we all go from different path, but ultimately the destination is one. And all the rivers, they come from different areas, but ultimately they go in the ocean, one great ocean. Then all cultures, different cultures, they all together form a world. So everything has this, ultimately they will come to the same end. Likewise, we all pray to different, we call gods by different names, we go to different places, but ultimately we all are praying to one God, and that is above everyone. So please read the chapter, children, and question answers you will get later as a PDF. Thank you.